the lockdown, most small businesses that went online were able to register profit amidst the pandemic. In fact, experts advise that with online platforms, businesses would be able to reduce on operational costs. Now, the Uganda Revenue Authority says that billions are being lost in uncollected tax and plans to impose a tax on online businesses. Well, we wait to see how this unfolds. Welcome to the Business Show. Uganda Securities Exchange lifts suspension on New Vision Trade Counter. Uganda Shilling weakens on corporate dollar demand. UEGCL takes over Namanve thermal plant. And petrol prices hit new high amid Ukraine tensions.
Central bank rate being at 6.5%, what it means, it helps in financialization.
There are people who just come and be like, Tina, we just want to support you because you're Ugandan, you're making these products from here. That is one reason why people just come and buy from us.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now recently, the central bank held the lending rate at 6.5% to spur recovery and also help businesses grow. On Views from the Top tonight, we speak to an economist from the Economic Policy Research Center on what more can be done to spur economic growth. So Paul, welcome to this interview. The central bank held its lending rate at 6.5%. Kindly paint a picture for us on what this means in relation to actual economic growth for Uganda.
My name is Paul Lakuma. I'm a research fellow at the Economic Policy Research Center, a leading think tank in Uganda, based in Makerere University, Kampala. The central bank rate being at 6.5%, what it means, it helps in financialization. As you know, finances are an enabler of an economy. And what that means is banks have what they call overnight lending, can lend each other at that rate, at that indicator rate of 6.5. Normally, the prime lending rate should have been that central bank rate plus inflation rate to cater for risk, assuming that inflation is a good measure of the risk in the economy. So you would expect that rate plus the inflation rate would be the prime lending rate. But that's not the case for Uganda. Why? One, there are so many other risks. There are so many other risks which cannot be effectively captured by the inflation rate. They are beyond the parameters captured by the inflation rate. The inflation rate is mostly consumer-based. It's built on things consumed at the household level, mostly food, energy products, and a couple of durables, which don't move so much. And it's dominated mostly by food products. So the changes in prices of food products, one would say it's not a good parameter to indicate other risks which are abound in the market. Ideally it should, but it doesn't. There are other risks. One, court cases, disputes between banks and clients, which are held up in the courts. There's an estimate that about 3 to 4 trillion is held up in disputes. That makes banks be risk averse, try to avert their risk. And to avert their risk, that's why you see the lending rates are 20 to 23%, which is beyond what you would expect. Another risk is non-performing loans, the ratio of non-performing loans and to liquidity. that if the ratio is beyond the threshold or near the threshold, banks would be afraid to lend at the rate which the CBR is indicating plus inflation, because it just suggests, non-performing loans suggest the ability of people, the players in that economy, to be able to repay, their ability and their willingness. It's also a matter not only of the ability, but the willingness or the culture of people in repaying money they have been lent. Other issues which have been cited, maybe there's need for more evidence, is some analysts suggest that the market is concentrated. It's concentrated with few big players, three or four big banks, and who tend to set market prices. They are the price setters, and the other banks are price takers. The smaller banks are the other 20 something banks are price takers, and these banks tend to have a lot of say in the market. That has also been suggested as a possible reason for lending rates, prime lending rates, to be as high as 23%. So that's what the CBR means in general. It's an indication from the lend of the last resort and the regulator of banks of how much at what rate should banks lend to each other. Then banks also have a rate at which they would lend to customers, which I said, it's that rate, the 6.5 plus inflation rate. You would expect the banks to lend at about 10 to 11%, but that has not been the case, apart from the last 2 years. And you know the reason why in the last 2 years we didn't grow at the expected rate. Of course, it was COVID. Whether that rate hurts growth, I would say no. Why? Because at the end of the day, a lot of our growth is explained by growth is a function of consumption, investment, government expenditure, exports. Yeah. A lot of our growth has been explained by consumption, mostly 70%. We are a consuming economy. Businesses have remained, in terms of investments, businesses have remained profitable. The costs have remained fairly, the cost of doing business. Government has done a lot of work in infrastructure to reduce the cost of doing business. In business development, we have a couple of business development services. Apart from finances, if you people tend to look at finance, I still agree, and I'm one of those who think finance is the biggest problem, but it's not the only problem. There are other problems which have been resolved. We have not resolved the financial problem, but we have resolved many other problems. Problems of days spent registering a business. We have reduced it fairly well. It's unfortunate that the World Bank Doing Business Survey has been discontinued. With all its problems and frailties, it still did capture some things accurately. And that's one of the measures we used to look at. Tax rates, they are not the fairest, but relative to other African countries, it's pretty much fair. Tax policy, there are efforts to reform the tax policy through the medium-term revenue strategy, and those efforts are bearing fruits. Roads. So the cost of business is going down, profits are going up. What other things are in investment? There's profit, there's cost. I've said the costs are going down, so that means profits of businesses are going up. There's interest. This is an area we have to work on. We are not yet there. As you have seen in the last MTN initial public offer, it did well. But I was a little bit disappointed by the turnout, but we are just learning this thing. I think there's need for more education and exposure and awareness on other forms of financing businesses. Rather than debt, there are other forms like equity, like the initial public offer done by MTN. I expected a bigger turnout than the 20,000 or so of private individuals who turned out. I expected a higher number, but still, nevertheless, it was a success. It was a successful initial public offer. Especially the institutional turnout was really good. Companies like NSSF did a very good job. So that's one area. So that's another area you measure in investment. The investment variable in measuring economic growth, there's interest. The other one is assets. As you know, land as a factor of production is a big factor in a lot of investments in Uganda. Machinery and buildings of recent, we have seen a growth in the construction industry, growth in a lot of industrial building development, industrial parks and stuff like that, buying of machinery. So depreciation of those assets is another variable you measure when you're measuring economic growth. The next one is government expenditure. You have seen in the last 10 years, there's been an intensive. Uganda has been like a construction site. There's been an intensive race. I would call it a race to narrow the infrastructure gap. Bridges, Jinja Bridge, the expressway, almost 3,000 kilometers of superhighways. My only critique to this is we have to make them more productive. We have to link them to economic activity. But otherwise, that has also contributed to economic growth. Our exports, the next variable, have also been rising year on year. Actually, what surprised me is during COVID, we exported more coffee than... I'm still to investigate what exactly happened, but we exported more coffee. I don't know if you read that. More coffee than...
I did.
Yeah, than the rest of the other periods. So, the lack of financing, it's a big constraint. Nevertheless, it has not hurt economic growth than you would expect. Why? Due to contribution of the other variables, which I've mentioned, consumption at the household level and at the private level, and also of other private organizations. Secondly, investments, which I said, profits have been pretty much good due to the reduction in cost of doing business. Costs have been low, profits have been high. It's slow, but the equity market is growing at a slow pace, not as you would expect, not where we want it to be, but it is growing. So that's also encouraging. It's encouraging to see.
You're watching The Business Show with me, Viola. Feel free to get in touch with me using the social media handles on your screen. We shall take a quick break, but The Business Show returns shortly.